So, yeah, it's been a while since the last History of Power Rangers. As such, I need to address a couple of things that have cropped up. Yes, I'm aware of the David Yost interview. Yes, I'm aware Power Rangers Samurai is coming to Nickelodeon in 2011. Yes, I will continue to do History of Power Rangers through that series once it concludes. Now, many of you have been very patient in waiting for these videos, and for that, I'm very grateful. Others of you have not been so patient, to the point where I'm actually taking time out of this review to talk about it. Let me say this once again, since apparently it was not made clear when this video series began. History of Power Rangers has no set schedule. The videos are done when they're done, and will be released when they're done. In case you haven't noticed, I've been more than a little busy the last few months. If you haven't noticed, wake up already! I attended Power Morphicon, FallCon, did a very complicated ending to an episode of Atop the Fourth Wall, released additional videos in October beyond my regular workload, did my regular workload, which consists of an episode of Atop the Fourth Wall every week despite conventions and other difficulties, one of those difficulties being moving into an apartment. In addition to that, people don't seem to realize how much work actually goes into these videos. Here's the process. I watch the entire series, which, for those of you at home, is around 40 episodes at 20 minutes each. That's roughly 13 hours straight if I was watching them all in one day, which I'm not. Oh, but it gets better, because I also am writing up a synopsis of the important plot points of the season, as well as writing down character notes, themes, etc., etc., which means I'm pausing the episodes so I can write. Once the season is completed, I have to finish my notes and analysis, and then I watch the next season and repeat the process. Yes, I had to finish watching Ninja Storm before I recorded the Wild Force review. Why? So I don't let my immediate feelings about it be the ones that I write. I give it time to settle and see how much of it is memorable. It helps the analysis and judgment of the series. And on top of all of that, I then have to record it and edit it all down to a few videos for your consumption. And oh yes, I need to also have my own life outside of it. So when will the next History of Power Rangers be out? When it's done. I'm sorry if I'm coming across as ungrateful or needlessly angry, since I'm not. I love that you all care about this series, and I'm doing everything in my power to get it done. But it's not easy, and it doesn't happen overnight. Asking me when the next one is going to come is not making it get done any faster. I have warned you all before that I'm in unfamiliar territory now, and it's harder for me to skip through stuff that I've never seen before. And I appreciate offers of people to point out what's filler and what isn't, but I have to make that evaluation for myself. And please, please, please avoid spoilers or telling me, skip this season, it sucks. It's History of Power Rangers, not History of Power Rangers, except for this season or this season. Every season will be watched, everything evaluated, everything will be given a fair chance to impress or disappoint. Like I said, I haven't watched these seasons before, and I want the chance to be surprised by things that happen. Stop telling me what's going to happen. You're only going to piss me off. The thing is, I want to have fun while I'm doing this. Constantly badgering me for the next videos does not equal fun. It makes it a chore for me, and if it becomes a chore for me, I will be disinclined to work on it.